Dragon is a super important character in One Piece, and fans have been dying to know more about him for ages. Finally, in a recent One Piece chapter 1097, we got a peek into Dragon's past, and turns out he used to be a part of Navy like his dad Garp. Garp really believed in Marines, but something made Dragon quit. We don't know the exact reason, so it's a big mystery. Considering Dragon's potential long tenure within the Navy, it's conceivable that he held a significant rank, possibly even as high as an admiral or at least a vice admiral, much like his father Garp. Unfortunately, the exact duration of his stay within the organization remains a mystery to the fans. Nonetheless, it's a fair guess that he was stronger than the average vice admiral during his time in the Marines. The fact that Dragon is well known by figures like Sakazuki suggests that they might have been colleagues in the Navy. Sakazuki's reference to Luffy as the Dragon's son reinforces a personal connection between the two characters, hinting at a possible grudge held by Sakazuki against Dragon. Before Sakazuki became an admiral, approximately 20 years ago during the Ohara incident, he was a vice admiral. At that time, Dragon has already been departed from the Marines, indicating that he might have held a vice admiral rank before leaving. This implies that Dragon left the organization before reaching the peak of his powers, choosing instead to continue his development as a member of a freedom fighter. The reason behind Dragon's departure from the Marines is rather straightforward. He came to realize that the Marines lack true justice. Each Marine officer upholds his personal concept of justice, whether it's the like of admirals or someone like Garp. Dragon, having his own sense of justice, found that Marines couldn't align with his ideals. Recognizing the corruption within the organization and its service to the Celestial Dragons, Dragon grew disenchanted and made his decision to forge his own path, distinct from the corrupt system. Subsequently, Dragon with Ivankon laid the foundation for the organization that would evolve into the Revolutionary Army. Initially known as Freedom Fighters, this small yet determined group, driven by Dragon and Ivankon's aspirations, sought to bring about profound change. Their actions, which is liberating oppressed towns, slowly gained attention and followers across the Four Blues, eventually catching the notice of figures like Kuma in the South Blue. The pivotal movement arrived within the raid of Sorbet Kingdom, where Dragon and Ivankon spearheaded a successful coup against a corrupt leader, freeing Kuma and the others and also at the same time significantly expanding their ranks. This marked the official genesis of the Revolutionary Army. As the Revolutionary Army gained momentum, Dragon orchestrated its expansion into a global force, utilizing a mercenary guise to fund their operations. The army took on perilous missions, spreading freedom to those in dire need. This gradual progression allowed Dragon's organization to gain influence, even becoming a topic of discussion at the Reverie. Continuing to expand, the Revolutionary Army strategized to have a presence in every corner of the world. Each sea was designated a commander, effectively covering the entire globe. Their operations aimed at liberating countries led to Dragon being labeled as the world's worst criminal, directly challenging the oppressive rule of the Celestial Dragon. In his quest for a just revolution, Dragon's rise to power reflects a character who navigated personal delusionments within the system and transformed it into a global movement, challenging the established order at a great personal risk. This portrayal paints Dragon as one of the most influential and powerful characters in the world of One Piece, driven by a steadfast pursuit of a fairer world. The Revolutionary Army's primary objective is to fight against the world government's rule over the world by defying political oppression and the corruption. According to Koala, their true purpose is to overthrow the tyrannical and hedonistical world nobles as well as the monarchs that support them. Most of the Revolutionary Army's efforts are focused on liberating individual islands from local governments that are under the world government, who are willing to oppress their own people to pay the heavenly tribute. They are shown to not target government-affiliated kingdoms that are benevolent to their people, like in the case of Alabasta Kingdom. These small revolutions becomes easier if the world government or its affiliates are in disarray. Due to being an independent militia, another goal of the Revolutionary Army is stockpiling arms in order to build up their military strength. Normally, the Revolutionary Army funds themselves by stealing from the Marines or receiving support from the kingdoms under their influence, much like the Yonkos. Furthermore, they monitored Don Quixote family's underworld activity for the purpose of obtaining the weapons that he traded and rescued their comrades who have been transformed and enslaved as toys. The arrest of Don Quixote Doflamingo allowed the Revolutionary Army to seize all the weapons manufactured on Resora. The revolutionaries master their forces by training young children into adulthood and provides contact information to normal civilians that desires not to be oppressed for being considered weak. The rapid development and the progress of their resistance movement agitated the government so much that they were required to initiate clandestine operations that were not known to the general public to disrupt their plans. Despite eventually initiating conspicuous and perpetual military hostilities against the Celestial Dragons, several prominent revolutionaries maintained the belief to only assist people so that they can be able to help themselves. Ivankon explains to the pleading Bentham that he is not a miracle worker, thinking that miracles only comes to those who are determined. According to Ivankon, he always questions the will to live of the nation he saves as revolutionary. This was substantiated when the four revolutionary commanders went to the Lulushia kingdom to protect the citizens from the Peachbeard pirate. Rather than saving the citizens by engaging the pirates directly, the commander instead empowered and supported the civilians so that they could fight against the pirate themselves by boosting citizens' strength and morale through Belobeti's devil fruit abilities, as well as incapacitating and stealing the pirates' weapon. King Thalassa Lucas once stated during the reverie that their ideals and actions were dangerous. People who joined the revolutionary army are considered notorious threats to the government, especially the high-ranking members. The leader, Dragon, is known as the world's worst criminal. The second-in-command, Sabo, engaged Marine Admiral Fujitora in a direct combat, and members like Emporio Ivankon and Inazuma were imprisoned in Level 5 of Impel Down. According to Nico Robin and Doflamingo, despite mutually opposing the world government and Marines, revolutionaries and pirates rarely cooperate. The two factions can become hostile to each other due to the conflicting objectives, not to mention two sides often try to loot each other. This was seen when the Blackbeard pirates attacked and destroyed the Revolutionary Army base at Baltigo to acquire weaponry stolen from Don Quixote pirates, and again when the Revolutionary Army commanders defeated the Peachbeard pirates to prevent them from raiding the port town of Lulushia Kingdom. However, they can occasionally collaborate to fulfill a mutual objective or defeat a common enemy. After the events of the Dressrosa arc, Rob Lucy realizes that Revolutionary had to use the chaos of the uprising incited by the Straw Hat Heart Alliance to seize munitions and evidence related to Doflamingo's black market activity. Upon learning that Luffy is the son of Leader Dragon, the Marines made it a top priority to Luffy to be eliminated due to his heritage. They have also been informed about the Chief of Staff Sabo's connection to the Straw Hat Pirates captain. The Revolutionary Army might be outnumbered, but they have proven to be the biggest challenge to the world government's authority. Their success mainly comes from the really strong members who are some of the mightiest characters in One Piece. Inazuma, he's a tough guy with a devil fruit power that turns his body parts into scissors. His strength isn't fully unknown, but cutting through anything makes him powerful. Koala, she was a former slave and is really skilled in fishman karate. Although she hasn't had a big fight yet, she is expected to show her strength soon. Belobeti, she is in charge of the Eastern forces and her ability to lift people's spirits and boost their powers using her devil fruit is quite something. Her bounty is also known to be really high. Next one is Lindenberg. He is a mink with strong haki and unique abilities in weapon making. He's proven himself by joining a daring mission and rescuing Kuma. Ivankon, he is a funny leader who can turn serious when needed and his devil fruit lets him control hormones, and he's shown his strength in battles many times. Morley, as a giant, he is incredibly strong and his devil fruit lets him mold ground like a clay. His bounty, the reward on his head, is high and likely to increase very soon in the future. Karasu, he is a commander of the North Army and has a unique devil fruit power that helps him to steal weapons. He is good at using haki and has shown his transporting abilities using crows. Bartholomew Kuma, he used to be the ruler of the Sorbet Kingdom and then joined the Revolutionary Army. His power to repel attacks and send opponents flying is quite something. He is among the strongest in the One Piece world. Sabo, he is the Chief of Staff and uses special fighting techniques like fire manipulation. His strength is incredible due to his haki skills and devil fruit powers. And then there's Monkey D. Dragon, the top leader of the Revolutionary Army. He is mysterious, but he has proven his strength by stopping Smoker easily. There is a rumor that he might be as strong as a fleet admiral, which is really big deal in the world of One Piece. The forces of the Revolutionary Army are divided into 5 armies, each of which operates in a specific region of the world. The G Army operates in the Grand Line, the North Army operates in the North Blue, the East Army operates in the East Blue, South Army operates in the South Blue, and the West Army operates in the West Blue. Each army is led by an army commander, and each commander has a deputy commander who assists them. The commanders and deputies of each army are on the screen right now. You can pause and read them if you want. During a meeting at Momoiro Island, Dragon inquired with Kuma about the mission's events, and Kuma confirmed the details. Subsequently, Koala received a call from Sabo through a Denden Mushi. However, when he attempted to disclose the shocking revelation about the empty throne, the island where he was hiding got destroyed, leaving Sabo in a precarious situation. After this unsettling series of events, Dragon had a conversation with Dr. Vegapunk, who delivered a grime message regarding his impending demise. As the Revolutionary Army focused on repairing Kuma, an unexpected turn of events occurred. Kuma, in the midst of the repairs, abruptly awakens and teleports away. This surprising incident startles the army, with Ivankon remarking their actual struggle was not to commence. Following Kuma's departure, Jiron, Ahiru, Ushiano, and Gambo noticed a ship in the distance near Kambaka Kingdom, prompting speculations about its nature, whether it posed a friendly or hostile presence. Ultimately, it was revealed that the ship carried Sabo, who had safely arrived at Kambaka Kingdom, accompanied by several citizens he had rescued before Lulushia Kingdom's obliteration. As Sabo reunited with the members of the Revolutionary Army, Bello Betty facilitated the citizens' induction into the army. Despite his arrival, Sabo was deeply troubled by the news of the reverie, fearing that it could endanger the other captains. In an effort to protect the army's members, Sabo opted for the confidential meeting limited to only Dragon and Ivankon, intending to shield the other captains from potential risk. Monkey D. Dragon's mysterious past uncovering in chapter 1097 marks a pivotal moment. His journey from leaving the Marines to forming the Revolutionary Army speaks volumes about his defiance against the oppressive world government. The army led by Dragon wages a courageous battle, boasting powerful members like Inazuma, Koala, Bello Betty, and others, challenging the Celestial Dragon's rule. Despite facing multiple oppositions, their unwavering spirit signifies the fight for justice. As the saga unfolds, their struggle and quest for freedom stands as the beacon of hope, etching a powerful legacy in the world of One Piece. And that's it for today's video, guys. That was the video about everything that you need to know about Dragon and his Revolutionary Army. What are your thoughts about this video? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos like this. And also check out some other videos related to One Piece over here. And that's it for today's video, and I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.